Hello and welcome to MFM. This is the second video on effect zone templates, compressor template. The first video basically explained how the effects parameters in your plugin relate to the CSI effects zone. Now I'm going to show you how to automatically generate that information in Reaper as a text file so you can copy and paste some of that across into your effects zone file. These automatically generated text files will appear in your zone raw effects files folder in your zones folder. Let's go and have a look at how you generate those files from Reaper. Open your action list and type raw effects in the filter. Only one option will come up. This is a toggle. When you open Reaper, it isn't on. So bear that in mind. Sometimes when it doesn't create text files, it's because you've probably got the toggle back to front. For what it's worth, I give it a hotkey of Alt Command and 4. So that's running. I'm going to stick a plugin on that channel. Go and look in the Zone Raw Effects Files folder, and you can see the text being generated for that plugin there. So I'm going to open that. Now we can easily copy information from this file into the Effects Zone file that we're going to create for this plugin. All text needs to be plain text, and if you're using a Mac and using Text Edit generally, that's running in rich text. You can switch it to plain text. And it's important that you do so, or there'll be characters created you can't necessarily see that you'll paste into your zone file. And to create the actual zone file, I downloaded a program called BB Edit Lite. I don't know what the PC equivalent of this is, but the important thing is that you write in plain text. Now, wouldn't it be great if all you did was copy and paste this text file into the zone file that you're going to make? Save that and off you go. Well, yes, it would, but that's not nature's way, I'm afraid. First of all, Reaper recognizes which plugin is which from the name inside the inverted commas. Also, until we modify it, the name displayed on the MCU will be the first six characters, so VST colon space G will be all I get for most of my plugins. With that in mind, it's worth remembering that how you name the text file is just for your own reference. Reaper's taking information from within the text file in relation to the plugin. Let me show you the order in which I do things so I don't overwrite templates and I correctly name everything. On the left is the generated text file and on the right is the compressor template you've downloaded. Copy and paste the zone VST name into the top. That means Reaper will recognize the plugin itself. Now I want the display name to look different, so I've put another inverted comma, space, GR. I always put a space at the beginning of every name, and then however long the name is, the names don't run into each other across the display. As soon as you've done this bit, save the file itself as the plugin name. And now, we're not going to overwrite the template. I've slightly updated the template since the video. It just makes it cleaner for you to look at on the screen, that's all. I've assigned Enter as the key to refresh all MIDI surfaces. The plugin button is going to show me what plugins are available on that channel. I could have up to 8. Pressing the rotary is assigned to opening the plugin, in this case plugin 1. In the template you downloaded, the correct names appear, but none of the faders and rotaries work like they're doing here. I'm doing this specifically to demonstrate something to you. If you don't insert a parameter number or you put something in there that it doesn't understand, it'll default to the effects parameter 0, whatever that might be. It varies plugin to plugin. So that's why everything became the gain. In the compressor template you've downloaded, I've put 99 as the effects parameter throughout all of these. I did that for two reasons. It leaves everything blank, and the fact I've put something there means it's very easy for you to copy multiple numbers vertically holding the Alt key, depending on your text editor, of course. I always have parameter assignments consistent across plugins. Fader 8 is always my volume out. I've assigned this to the gains parameter number, which is 0. The forward slash out is just a reminder for me to remember what Fader 8's doing, to actually change what Fader 8's display looks like. Well, let's do it on Fader 7. Just put inverted commas. This is in. I'm going to put it in capitals with a space before, obviously. And that's how it would display on the MCU. Let's take the whole thing further with another plugin. As soon as I open the plugin, that should have created a text file in the Zone Raw Effects file folder. I can open that. And as always, my first fader is assigned to attack. Just ignore fader 3 there. In module 2 and 3, attack is working fine on the first fader. I want the timing in module 1 to work on the first fader as well. So just copy the information from fader 1. Duplicate that directly below. Though I'm going to give this the name time, it won't appear. It'll still be ATT that will appear, but this is just good practice. I'm going to assign parameter 4, hold the Alt key, and you can paste vertically. Save the file, refresh Reaper surfaces, go to the plugin zone. And now fader 1 is assigned to control timing in this plugin, as well as attack. I'm just going to go ahead and assign a few more parameters. It's worth knowing that nothing's going to update on the MCU display until you've saved the file and refreshed all MIDI surfaces. Look in your action list for that and assign it a hotkey. I'm using Enter on the MCU. And now if you look at the display, the in and the out are assigned. Rotary 1 is assigned to the high pass filter. The way I'm changing the display to show faders and rotaries, I'm using Shift as a modifier to show rotaries. So that's the high pass filter in the frequency as I'm turning the rotary. And as soon as I stop holding Shift, we're looking at the faders again. So toggling between the two. This is already programmed into the compressor template you've downloaded. Here I've just inserted parameter 99 to keep the displays clear. I don't think I'll ever use a plugin with 99 parameters without going insane. If you've also downloaded and are using the zone file, then this is how it'll work. In global view, just the faders and all the buttons will work as normal. The plugin button shows you the plugins on that channel. At this point, we're still in the global view zone, so all the faders, pans, etc. work. To go to the effect zone, instantiate the plugin. As I mentioned, you could instantiate 1 to 8 plugins by pressing 1 to 8 rotaries. To switch the Mackie display from the faders to the rotaries, just hold the Shift key. Including the initial state and the 4 modifiers, for example, one fader can be assigned to 5 separate parameters with a corresponding display. And we haven't even started to look at buttons. Anyway, if you like the video and it's been useful, please like and subscribe, blah blah blah, and we'll see you in the next one.